Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Lab. In this video, we will practice a Power BI data profiling related question. And the question is, you are profiling data by using Power Query Editor. You have table named report that contains a column state. The distribution and quality data matrix for the data in state is shown in the exhibit. So in exhibit, we can see we have state column. And for that, we can see we have 69 distincts. And 4 unique. We have to answer for 2 questions. The first question is, there are how many different values in state including nulls? And the question B is, there are how many non-null values that occurs only once in state? So this is the drag and drop type of the question, where we have to drag the value from the options to the answer area. Now let's look at this profiling in the Power BI. So here in Power BI, we have table name called report, and that we have column state. And after that, we have column num with 1 as the default value. And when we click on the state, and if we go to the view option, there we get the column distribution option. So let's click on this. And here we can see we are getting the same values, that 69 distinct and 4 unique value under the distribution, as what we have given in the exhibit in the question. Now let's understand what is the column distribution meaning and how it works. So when we click on the column distribution, it shows us how many the distinct values are available in this particular selected column. So here on the bottom left corner, you can see we have 134 rows in this table. And out of this 134 rows, we have 69 distinct values in this column. And thereafter, we have 4 unique values. That means there are 4 values that are not repeated in this column. And remaining all are the repeated, maybe for 2 times or more than that. So let's verify that. So first of all, as we know, we have 134 rows and there are some duplicates. Let me first remove this column of distribution. Let's remove the duplicates. And now here we can see, after removing duplicate values, we are getting 69 rows in this column. So with this, we can conclude the 69 it was showing under the distribution was the distinct values within this column. So let me remove this remove duplicate step for now. Now we have all 134 rows back in our table. Now let's verify the second question. That is, what is the 4 unique values into this? So for that, we have to identify the records which are occurred only once. So for that, let's go to the report view. And here in report view, let's plot one visual as matrix. And here in matrix, let's add this column state. And thereafter, let's add the num column. And let me expand this. Now here you can see we are getting all the list of state values along with the sum of the num, and wherever we are seeing sum as the 1, that means we have only 1 record, and wherever we are getting 2 or more than that as the sum of the num, that means we are getting this value more than once in this table. So let me apply the sorting on the sum. And now here we can see the values which are only once in this table, we are getting only 4 records, that is Alabama, Alaska, Arizona and Arkansas. So with this, we can conclude that there are 4 unique values and 69 distinct values in this table. So let's go back to our question. So here in a question A, there are 69 different values in state including nulls, and in question B, there are 4 non-null values that occurs only once in this state.